Alright, Mr. Nygren here. This is Torchlight 1. It's only playable in single player. I originally bought two versions of this game in the store because I thought I could play, you know, on two computers with a friend, but it only had single player. Torchlight 2, on the other hand, has multiplayer. So, we will play this game because I want to play this story before playing anything new. I haven't played this before. I've played it with this character before. She is on level 6. And I don't remember anything. I also played it on my older computer that broke. So that save is gone forever. But I played it on this more recent computer with this character. And yeah, I'm level 6. And I played about 2 hours. But I will restart because now I'm recording. I didn't record when I played before. I probably played more than a year ago. Alright, I want to play this game. It's like Diablo 2. It's probably the same, some of the same creators that created Diablo 2 before they left Blizzard. Now they are working on Torchlight instead. Torchlight 3 is releasing soon. Or have been released, I'm not sure. I think it's soon. Anyway, Torchlight 1. I played Torchlight 2 and 1 in the past. But I haven't finished them. I only played 6 levels with this character. And then Torchlight 2. I believe I played with my sister during the summer of 2015. We sat on each of my both computer. I have 2 computers. The other one has broke, as I said, the one I used. So that save is gone now. But she used this computer, and yeah, that save is probably still around. Anyway, we'll play Torchlight 1, a new character. So, we have 2 options of pets. We can have a dog or a cat, and we can name him. Or use the first name. I think we will use the dog, of course. And name him Wolfie. So. And then we have 3 character classes to choose from. Select hero class. Destroyer. The Destroyer excels at melee combat and channels the power of his ancestors to smite his foes. And then we have the Alchemist. Alchemist, probably a mage. The Alchemist channels the power of Ember to attack from afar and summon minions to his side. And then we have the female character, the Vanquisher. Vanquisher. The Vanquisher is an expert marksman. Uses trap to confuse and debilitate her foes. So probably a mix between the assassin in Diablo 2 and the Amazon. Well, this is a mix between probably the druid and the sorceress, and this between the barbarian and the paladin. Anyway, we will use the Vanquisher, the female, as I had already used her before. I just need to restart it. Alright. Her name will be Vale. Alright. And we can already from the start play on all the difficulties. We can play easy for players looking for casual fun, and normal for players new to action RPGs, and hard. Action RPG veteran should start here. And masochist only very hard. And we can use the hardcore option like in Diablo 2. That means when the character dies, she will be permanently dead. And we will never be able to get her back. I don't like hardcore. I think it's too hard. And very hard is probably too hard too. But we will use the hard difficulty. I used that before, so. I'm a veteran of Diablo 2. I've also played some others. I must admit I felt a bit relieved. Petty assignments often signal the end of a vanquisher's career. I came to restore the flow of Ember, but the darkness below Torchlight ran far deeper than the mines. It would be a test of both my skill and my conviction. Evil must be torn out at its root, and this one had buried itself deeply.
Welcome to the town of Torchlight. Explore the area by left-clicking to move around. Visit the denizens of the town to shop or find quests to perform. When you're ready, enter their mines to begin your journey. We have zoomed out view here. We can attack, but it will probably cost mana. We can shoot in the town, unlike in Diablo 2. Alright. Don't know if we can change the angle of the map. We can't do that, probably. We can zoom in, though. See everything up close like this. And play like this, like it's supposed to be played when we fight. But in the town we could use this zoom. Speak to some guys. We have Westman, the Ember Scholar here. These monster attacks are disrupting my works. I am Westman, a scholar of Ember. I traveled to Torchlight to study the vast supply of Ember below. But these creatures make it impossible to obtain the samples I need. Perhaps you have more courage than these miners. If you brave the tunnels and bring me a sample of gleaming ember, I will reward you well. Should not be difficult. Look for the ember on the first floor of the mine. Yes, I will accept that quest. And then we have Duran the Transmuter here. Duran the Transmuter combines treasure to create new items. I cannot concentrate with these monsters about. You have items to combine, you will have to come back another time. Alright. Have the map in the corner. You can also do it like this so it will be more clear to us. Right. Have a woman here. Tria Gemseller. This game is from 2009, I believe. If that seer hadn't arrived to fight these monsters, I would already have packed up my gems and left town. Please help her if you can. I have a chest. This is your inventory screen. Drag weapons and armor into the appropriate slots to equip them. Drop items by dragging them into the play area. Disable items may be activated by right-clicking on them. To use items on your pet, drag them to the pet bowl icon at the top left of the screen, or hold shift while right-clicking them. Alright. This is your stash. You can place items here for long-term storage if your inventory is getting full. Offload some artifacts here, just like in Diablo 2. Alright, we will speak to this guy, Tarn the Merchant.
Well, hello.
This is the merchant interface. Drag items from the left to the right to buy them. Vice versa to sell. You can perform an instantaneous transaction by holding shift while clicking on an item. You can also buy and sell from your pet's inventory located in the bottom left. So that's exactly like Diablo 2. So we can buy potions and turn portal scrolls and identity scrolls here. Nice. Are there any other guys we can speak to here? We have more than one stash, storage stash here. A bridge here we can cross. See what is up around here. It's been years since I played this. At least 2015 or 16 or something like that. I played Diablo recently. Ah, we have an enemy there. Let's help them out.
Brink, over here! I can't hold them back much longer.
You all right, Syl? Rest here a while. I'm going ahead to finish the job.
It's no wonder Master Ulrich sent for my help. The Ember Mines are overrun with these creatures. His letter was urgent, but I had no idea how dire things had become. I am Syl, and that was my companion, Brink. We've only just arrived in Torchlight, and it looks like we're going to need some help. You look capable, and I can pay you well. Please, catch up to Brink before he gets himself killed.
Yes, I accept. Let's move here to the mine entrance. So we are already entering the mines.
In Torchlight and began my exploration of the tunnels below. These mines are vast and aglow with ember. I've never seen so rich a vein. Miners labor to extract it and take no heed of my warnings. I cannot blame them. I, too, could not resist the pull of ember. This ember is the same as that which afflicts me. The taint within it resonates with the corruption in my bones. I can feel it so clearly now. Blight springs from the depths and flows up through the veins. To purge myself of this evil, I must find the source.
All right, so we are inside of the cave. I like the graphics in this game. It's from 2009 and still looks very good. All right, and it didn't have a lot of characters, so we will use the zoomed out menu. If I click on one, I will use the health potion and the mana potion on the second button, and the ricochet on the third. You can also right click to use that attack. We have some enemies here, some rats. Time to clear the mines of those rats, the kobolds I believe they are called. We have a spider here. Your mana is low. Mana is used to perform skills or cast spells. Mana recharges over time. Mana recharges over time, but for a quick boost, drink a mana potion by right clicking on it. You may also press the corresponding number key of any potion mapped to the quick slot bar at the bottom of the screen. I already know this. The basic attacks. I like the animations in this, they are great. This game is certainly better looking than Titan Quest, which is a game from 2007 or 8. That is similar, where you play like in the ancient Greek mythology. Alright, we will attack. We have some ally there that we can speak to. I will speak to him.
Hello.
Miner. Watch out for any open shafts. Critters have been lurking down them and leaping out and at unsuspecting miners. Gives me the shivers. Alright, let's kill them. So these are Rattlin. Kobolds are from Warcraft, I believe, but they look kind of like them. So that's why I remembered it wrongly. But they are called Ratkin. Or something. Rattlin or something like that. I think we will go back because I might have missed something. I want to kill everyone in the area.
Hello.
Yeah. These tunnels are rich with veins of ember. You can see it gleaming everywhere. I'll make a fortune. We have a chest here. We got leather gloves. Good that we went back. So the inventory. Leather gloves, but they are unidentified. Let's identify them. And the bow is already identified. So we equip the bow. No, we didn't. Let's equip the gloves too. And the bow. Let's see here. I already had a bow. Yeah. So what's the difference? Two-handed, 22 damage per second. They are exactly the same, I see. Alright. Skill menu. Haven't leveled up yet. We have the experience bar down there. So we will move on. Towards the tunnels here. Yeah. And stairs up, then we will go to the other side, because I don't want to miss out on anything. So we will go here later when we are about to enter the next level of the place. I need to go drink soon. Do that after I'm done with this, with the mines section. I believe I played the mines in the past. I might have played a little more than that, but I don't know. Gleaming Ember. Nice, we got some Gleaming Ember here. You have completed a quest. To receive your reward, travel back to the town and speak to the individual with a question mark above their head. Use the town portal scroll to return directly to the Torchlight. I don't really need to do that right now. Let's kill the enemies here. Doors. So I missed supposed to those attacks. But we won there. Got some new stuff, potions and stuff. Let's see here, we have a leather mantle. I will identify it and equip it immediately. It isn't visible though. Didn't change anything on her looks. We have some enemies here. They're rattling. Three units of rattlings here to kill. Your health is low. To heal yourself and avoid an untimely demise, right click on a health potion to drink it. You may also press the corresponding number key of any potion mapped to the quick slot bar at the bottom of the screen. I don't think my health is low too. If I alt click, the name of stuff arrive, just like in Diablo 2, by the way. So we will see here, we have a Gleaming Ember there. Got some stash, that's probably just money or something. Alright, let's continue. Ah, that attack actually pierces through the enemy, so they attack many at once, that's cool. It pierced through them.
I don't have enough mana.
All right. We need to take the potions there. I see, I'm about to die. I looked at the pet's health and I looked at health. I looked here, but that's the pet. Here is my health, this bar. And this is my mana, I see. I looked at the wrong place. Didn't look like I was dying. So, you gain a level. Click on the stats up and skill up buttons on either side of the screen to apply your newfound wisdom. Good. Mana potion barrel. Destroyed. Okay, skills first. So we have the marksman, we have the rogue. We have new stat points to distribute. Click the button next to each attribute to improve that aspect of your character. You also have new skill points that may be used to improve your character's abilities in the skill menu. I already know that. So we have the rogue, we have the arbiter, and we have the marksman. So, marksman is probably good for the stuff I'm doing. So I will go for the marksman, actually. This requires level 2. Range weapons, expertise, mastery of bows, pistols, crossbows, and rifles. Requires level 1. What do I have then? I have 1 point remaining. I see, I can give myself these things. -1 to range equipment requirements. plus 4 to range weapon damage. Inflicts 100% of weapon DPS. We will go for this one. It's a passive skill, I believe. Yeah. So that's all we could do for now. We will go for the marksman. I like the Amazon in Diablo 2, so. Alright, and then the character sheet on C. So she could use some dexterity and probably say we have magic defense. She could probably use some magic and some strength. And that's it. And we destroy that gate there.
I don't have enough money.
Good, we took care of them pretty easily. You've discovered a socketable item. Socketable items imbue your weapons and armor with new magical properties when inserted. If you discover an item with socket, simply install the gemstone by dropping it onto the item. I'm surprised that the creators of this game didn't make the first one multiplayer. Seeing as Diablo 2 had multiplayer and Diablo 1 had multiplayer, so I don't know why they would not have multiplayer in this one. Fortunately, the second game has multiplayer, so that's good. Skeleton showed up there. Let's just kill everyone in the mines on the first level. Alright, health potion there. Town portal scroll. We killed both at once. Good. Got some stuff here, a mysterious rifle. Alright. Town portal scroll, we don't have any. Yeah, we have identify. Frost scepter. Toxic frost scepter. 25 damage per second. Critical hit chance. We don't need such stuff. Now we want to use a ranged weapon. But we have Grandpa's quick load here. If we compare them, 22 damage with the bow. And Grandpa's quick load, 51 damage per second. Two-handed, physical damage 13 to 26, and the fastest attack speed, socket 0 to 1, can be socketed, 12% faster cast speed, plus 4 critical hit chance, and 4% increased magic find, increases missile range by 2 meters. Of course I will get this. So yeah, we have some pretty good ranged unit now. Ranged weapon, I mean. I wasted some mana there trying out some attacks. Alright, let's continue. I wonder if it's possible to change the angle of the map. It might be, but I don't really know how. This is just the same areas we already been at. We've already been here. Let's remove the inventory there. Ah, we can move here to the stairs down. We can move down here. And the other one was moving up. We will of course visit both places. I believe the other one is the right one to take first. They are kind of marching in circles now. Yeah. I need to find my way back.
one unit to kill, to an enemy to kill. Let's go to the stairs. Level up or whatever first. There's a chest here with small cannon. I'll take a look at it too. I'm identified. We don't have a identify scroll. Identified ring there. So we have 3 Tarn portal scrolls, we don't need to waste them. Here was the door we hadn't visited before. Shrine of mana, we got more mana there. And we killed those guys pretty easily. Nice. Alright, so we're not done here yet. Gold. In this game we don't need to click on everything. That's an upgrade from Diablo 2. We can just move on them. We have a chest here as well.
My health is low.
Fuck, I failed. But lose 541 experience. Select at the entrance of this floor. Yes, we lost some gold. 54 gold actually. I was an idiot and didn't check my health. Alright, we took that one out. Now let's get the stuff from the chest. Alright, we have an identify scroll there. Ruby hatchet. Leather helmet. An identified ring. Let's go for the ring. Currently, to have a ring, it will give us 3% faster cast speed, plus 2 ice damage, plus 2 mana. We have no more identify scrolls currently. So you look like this now. Music is also kind of reminiscent of Diablo 2. Stairs up. That's probably the start, but let's move up. Should we? No, let's move down. The enemies might respawn otherwise, and I don't want that. Maybe we just return to where we started in the past. We need to go to that lower level. Of the mines. So we just need to go there now. So yeah, it's a great atmosphere, very reminiscent of Diablo 2, so it certainly is a good game, and it's deserving of at least one playthrough. I don't want to play the second game without someone else in a co-op mode, but this game is totally a single player, so you'll have to do. Holding shift while clicking on item will cost blah blah blah, alright. Alright, let's move down here first. And we healed in time. We heal ourselves in time there. Just kill everyone. So they are called Verkulen here. So it's a different beast. Get down close to the action.
prepare another one. Can play like this. It'll be more like a surprise what the units will show up. Or we can play the other way. This is the way I used to play Diablo 2. You had no other choice. This is also pretty cool. It's harder if I play like that. I wasted a health potion there. Alright, an unidentified ring there. He just detonated some bomb there. Alright, let's take all the gold. This place. We'll take that chest too. Just need to be prepared in case an enemy spawns again. Didn't. So, inventory. An identify scroll. And an unidentified belt. Let's identify it.
I can't.
Spike trash of protection. We need to be level 4 in order to use it. Unfortunately. Gives 2 armor, plus 4 fire resistance, plus 1 ice resistance, 5% increased magic find, increases all poison damage by 2, plus 4 defense attribute point bonus. Alright. Alright, we're done there. I got a new potion, so that's good. They were easily taken care of. Alright, so these monsters were easily killed. We need to go and take that gold there. And that thing over there as well. Identify scroll, perfect. Leather helmet. 3% faster cast speed, plus 1% increased magic find. Let's go for it. So the character, level 3 probably. We need to bring up the skill and give ourselves the ricochet. Fire a ricocheting projectile from the active ranged weapon. Inflicts 100% of weapon DPS damage per second. Alright. That's good actually. Zoom in. Hard to play like that. We need to be able to click on enemies far away. We can't move there. We need to go down here. Nice. Alright, that we'll have to do for now. That thing there. My dog took care of him, Wolfie. We had to heal because we had low health. There was a bigger monster there, but he wasn't a boss. It was kind of easy to take care of. I believe I have defeated the first boss of this game. Some slimes there. Not sure what they are named. pretty dangerous, those guys. They have some electric shock attacks in close combat. Nice. They were taken care of. There we have another one. Rock troll. Let's kill that monster. So we still haven't gone over there and explored that area. I believe we have been everywhere here. Let's continue on the path. Your inventory is full. Either drop unwanted items or give them to your pet by opening your pet's inventory and dragging them items to empty slot. I see. The pet can also have stuff. Pet. This is your pet's inventory. Your pet can carry as many items as you can. You can also have your pet pick up items directly from the ground by holding shift. Click on them. Your pet can also keep a limited selection of items to improve their abilities. Alright. Leather helm, one armor. Let's see here. Leather helm could be given to the pet.
Not possible. That is impossible.
It's not possible. They can have spell, ring, amulet. Drag a spell, alright. Not that much. Let's see, we have ring. Leather sash. They are not identified. Let's use the town's portal scroll. Return to the town. Need to sell some stuff to you.
Hello, friend.
Alright, let's sell the bow. I don't think we need a scepter. Small cannon. Don't need it either. The swords. Right, we sold some bad weapons there. Crack deep ember, leather mantle, leather helm. Sell that too. Ashen scepter. Let's sell it. We sell everything bad. Crack flow ember. By trash of protection, leather sash. I fucked up there.
Watch your back. Good day. It's not a scan.
Let's see, do we have any sash equipped? I had two, and that was one defense worse than the other, so let's sell it. Need to identify all of this stuff. Skelanus weapons, armor. I don't need anything from him then.
Well, hello.
We need this. Price 25. we will buy some more of these. We need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6. Don't want to buy too many, so we need some extras, maybe. Maybe we could use 9 in total. In case we find more stuff.
Good journey.
Alright, and now we will identify all this stuff. So the new ring, the 2 sting copper ring, gives 4 poison plus 4 poison damage. While the one I have equipped has let's see here. Amulet ring. Could have 2 rings, that's good. We have the virulent wobble hatchet. Virulent wobble hatchet. 30 damage per second plus 2 poison damage. We'll sell that one. And we have the spike trash of protection. We just need to level up to use that one. Unidentified ring, 3% increased magic find. Actually, it could be good. And faster cast speed. Let's see, we will give this to the pet. We have a leather helmet there. Let's equip it. So now we got the leather helmet. Good. But the one I have has 4 armor and this has 3 armor, 3 feather cast speed. This one looks a lot like a sorceress. It really does.
Were you drawn here by the lure of Ember? Perhaps my master was as well. Master Ulrich called me here. There's no sign of him in town. These creatures ambush us as we were about to enter the mines. I have attacked Ulrich as well, but he would not be overcome so easily. I need time to question the townsfolk and recover from that. Brink has been with me for a long time now. Please, watch over him.
Alright, let's check the settings. Sound volume could be higher. So,
hiya.
Speak to this girl. Spell summon flaming sword 2. Learn summon flaming sword 2. Nice map scroll. Perplexing eerie necklace. That's cool, we can summon a flaming sword if we have 1998 in gold or whatever. We need to be level 7 too. Summon archers. Summons a pack of 3 non-moving skeletal archers to attack your foes. That's cool too. But we need to be... we need to have 1435 in gold. Alright. Fireball one. Alright.
Bye!
Hello!
I'm a troll, but I am the great bard Trill. Perhaps you've heard of me. No. That's the problem, really. Despite my astonishing talent, word of my ascendancy has not yet spread among the masses. My ability is beyond question, but perhaps I have not yet found a tale truly worth telling. Perhaps your heroic deeds will inspire me. A beast known as Vanquisher has been emerging at night to prowl about the Torchlight. He is said to be a bat-like creature with great power. His lair is said to be on the third floor of the mine. Slay him and I will immortalize your battle in verse. Sure, I will take that mission. Let's speak to her again.
By the lure of Ember? Perhaps my master was as well. Master Ulrich called me here. There's no sign of him.
Alright, nothing to do there.
What can I do?
This is the enchantment interface. Place items here and pay a fee to receive random enchantments. Enchant.
I don't really need that.
Well, hello.
This is the transmutation interface. Place items here and attempt to combine them with the transmute button. There are many types of transmuting items, so try many combinations. Decline. We need to speak to this guy, that's why I went here. One of the reasons. Ah, I see you found the gleaming amber. I hope it wasn't too much trouble. Here's your reward. This is a fine, clear piece, but still there is something odd about it. All of the amber from Torchlight seems to have a special quality. Well, I soon understand it better. So you got some experience and some fame. Destroy items, recovering gems inside. Interesting.
Don't waste my time.
Let's bring up the map. Speak to the guy again. Amber is the essence of magic and it assumes aspects of its environment. That is why amber from different locations can appear and behave completely different. I've heard of a vast necropolis buried below the mines. Deathlace amber can sometimes be found in such places. Studying such a rare type of amber is a long-held dream of mine. You'll bring me any you find, won't you? Accept.
You have begun a new quest.
Someone here too. It isn't worth the risk. Why won't my husband see that? There are other amber mines in the world. We should take Albert and find work at one of them. They may not be nearly as rich, but at least they're not full of monsters. Hi. This guy. With a mine full of monsters, this load of amber may be the last we ever hauled out of here. If the ember stops flowing, Torchlight can't survive long. Maybe it's time for me to move on. Can't move up the stairs. There's the mines. Let's see if there was anything we could sell. Sell this too. The town portal scrolls there. Cracked flow ember, cracked deep ember, leather mantle. What's we gonna?
I got things to do.
Identify that one too. Rose leather mantle, 3 armor, increases all fire damage by 2%. The other one gave plus 24 health. That will replace it. No change in the look though. Alright, we will sell the other one. Sell the helmet. Sell the this mantle as well. Swift Chaos Gem. Won't use the gems for now.
It's not a scan.
Hello there.
I built a home here, and I'm not going to let those monsters drive me away. There's still good amber in those tunnels.
Hello.
Hope I can get back to the tunnels soon. I'm not used to all this fresh air. Alright, let's get back to the tunnels. Scroll, of course. Kill those monsters there. Another identify scroll was found. Kill the spider over there. And we leveled up. Awesome. Some rock trolls over here.
thought it was easy to take care of too. This gun is pretty strong. No enemies over there. Not here either. On this side will probably be enemies. Shrine of Mana, we just got full mana bar. Full mana bar. And we killed those guys.
You after me? She must have thought I was in over my head again. Well, she's right. These monsters are getting stronger and I could use your help. I'm going after the fiend that was attacking Syl on the bridge. Will you join me?
Accept. So we have a store here. Some guy. We don't really need to buy anything here. Let's just kill all of them. They can't kill my new ally. Because I don't think he's mortal. In Diablo II, the barbarians weren't immortal. That would join you in the fifth act.
Insufficient mana.
I just restored my mana there. Good. We're done there. So we are still not. We need defense 10. To use that. Let's see here, we have leveled up. So we will increase our defense to level 10. And then we will also increase our magic and strength and the dexterity, of course. And we're done there. And the skill. Rogue, needle lock, firing an arc of 5 darts that pierces faces. Sure. Lightning bomb. Alright, we're done here. So, I sometimes manage to click on them and go close to them. Click on the wrong thing. So they move close. So that's not good. Alright, spell heal. You found a spell scroll. In the spells tab of your inventory, you can right click on the scroll or drop it into one of your spell slots to learn it, and you'll gain a new ability. You can also teach your pet spells by dropping them into the appropriate slots in their inventory. That's awesome. So let's do that. So I can use the spiked stash of protection. It will give me plus 5 fire resistance, plus 1 ice resistance, 5% increased magic find, increases all poison damage by 2%, and plus 5 defense attribute bonus. Let's use that. And then I believe we had found some scroll. To learn some new skills. Let's see. Smart leather. Spells, it's here. Learn heal self. Sure. You have inscribed a spell to your spellbook. You may now cast it as you would any other skill. Skills and spells can be mapped to the quick slots on the bottom of the screen by clicking on them. Good. And that means I have a new skill. Tentative scroll, temporal scroll. Right, we will of course add a heal self skill there. And this skill. So right mouse button, skill, needle arc. That's that attack. And the heal self. It'll be tab. Alright. back and forth like that. Alright. Basic attack is doing this kind of prefer the other attack. Let's see here, left mouse button and we could use that, but I prefer if this is the green one and the other one is the blue one. So on 3 I will use the needle arc, and on right mouse button I will use the ricochet, which is better in my opinion. The other one might be better against many enemies, but just kill them. That's some big monster there. It's a boss.
I don't have enough money. Insufficient money.
Good, we won. Inventory. Already have gloves. All right. We didn't get anything interesting there. Let's move on. And it's dead. We got some stuff there. Right, let's move back in case I missed anything. I don't want to miss anything. So inventory, unidentified staff. Let's identify. 62 damage per second. 3% faster cast speed, critical hit, it requires magic 14. You don't really need that, as we're not a caster. A mage, I mean. All right, what was that? Gun, I see. And we destroyed some gate there, and we found a lot of treasure inside.
A trap has been sprung.
I wasted a health potion there. Managed to click 2 times. So we have a new ring. +2 poison resistance. 1% increased gold find. 2 electrical resistance. Alright. +4 poison damage can be removed. So we're done there. Let's move here. We've been here already. already. We came from this side. Let's move down then. The new potion. Let's kill that rock troll. And we're done here. Good. Now we can continue down that path that we were going. And watch her run in zoomed in view. It's just harder to play like this. And you can't see the enemies. Some gold there by killing that rock troll and the other gun. Rattlings. Rattlings there. Alright, we need to find our way now. There's no way to go here. We're going here, yeah. And we leveled up. Awesome. Oops, I shouldn't have gone there. I managed to click too soon. I'm afraid there's a boss down here. We will be very careful now. Let's place a town portal scroll and return to town. We'll sell some stuff. Don't need melee weapons, just sell them. And the outdated ring and the bad stuff. Don't need a staff either. Warper speed. Need to identify those things. Let's sell stuff first. We're down there. Inventory. Scroll of identify. We have a skillful lash and scepter. We have the skillful warped spear. And motley leather boots. They were better. They gave plus 12 health, increases all physical attacks and elemental damage by 2%. Let's equip that. Actually, our looks changed. From red boots to now blue. Nice. Can I have your armor when you're done with it? A gnome. Nice. Name Albert. So that's Albert. They talked about maybe it's a boy. Alright. Let's speak to this guy again. And sell this stuff. And the leather boots here will be sold as well. And return. So this fiend is named what? Lungdat the Ageless. Lungdat the Ageless, I see. Some kind of minor boss, I believe. Good. But not the real boss, of course. Got some gear there as well. Kill some rattlings here. And now they will swarm us again. Let's kill them. another chest. Lots of gold. Let's identify some stuff. Smart leather belt, yes. But it's not as good as the one I have. Leather armor. Pricky leather armor. Let's equip it. Cool, we've got a new look. So the old look is like this. Big difference. Not as much skin now. She looks kinda like a pirate. Alright. There and we refilled our health. Kill everyone. Slay these monsters. Rattlings. That's a big one. Cap Goosun the Butcher, minor boss again. Kill everyone. Alright, we're done there. That was easy. Up that identify scroll. The fishing hole down there, I don't know what that means.
You have triggered a trap.
Trap again. You're killing off these monsters. Let's refill our health. Destroy that barrel. Fishing hole, what is that? Got nothing. Got nothing. I don't understand how to use this. Ah, that's how you do it. So you can fish in certain locations. You caught a muck fish. Wonder what that will do. So a muckfish transforms into a pet goblin hunt for 120 seconds. Right click to feed fish to pet. Transform into a pet goblin hunt for 120 seconds. Shame it's limited in time. Try again if you get something else. Mother, that was easy actually when I understood how to do it. You caught a tunnel shark. Transform into a burrower for 120 seconds. Let's continue. Fuck, I was too fast there. We'll try again. Looper Jelly. Transform into a gel for 120 seconds. No, I was too soon there. I got tricked. Too soon. Need to not do that. Need to wait until it is red now. Got a bat fish. Interesting. Perform it a Verkulin for 120 seconds. Right, I will see what else we can get. Got a tunnel shark. That's probably the same as I already had. Yes. Try another one. Last one. Caught a fish containing tasty fish meat. What? I see, tasty fish meat. 600 health recovered over 2 seconds. Health mana recovered over 2 seconds. Alright. Alright, let's move on. Could continue, but I want to continue the game. Right, they're dead. Something is in the way, even I fire there. Just kill that big guy. I used a mana potion, it wasn't intended. But I kind of needed it anyway. Air Vark Baser here. Guy.
Quest.
And they are dead.
Your food has increased.
I have a lot of items here. Spell summon zombies, that's cool. Wolf identity. Mana potion. Let's see here, what the fuck was that? Spells. Summon zombies requires level 1. Summon a pack of uncontrollable zombies to attack your foes. That's awesome. I want that. Alright, reminds me of the Necromancer. Alright, let's use the. Tabs here. Tab and. Heal ourselves. Alright, and tab again. And the skills. Summon zombies, that's awesome. On 4 we can summon zombies now. Let's see, summons a pack of uncontrollable zombies to attack your foes. Mana cost 20, cooldown 30 seconds. And 40 seconds summon duration. It sucks that there is a summon duration. It should be there until they die, I think. Anyway, plus 10 health, plus 5% health stolen. Alright, awesome stuff. We'll use it against the boss later. Let's continue the journey into the mines. Basic attack against this guy. Didn't need to use anything else. Ah, another place where we could get some good stuff. And they are dead. Alright, and we're up here. Another rattling there. And another one. They're easy to kill now. That's a rattling foreman. Slightly stronger rattling. Alright. Thank you. Let's kill that guy. Good. And they are down. I don't want to miss anything. Let's move that, move back. See if we missed any gold or anything. Barrel. That's the problem with the zoomed out, zoomed in menu. There's some evil guys down there as well. Unfortunately, I can't see anything here. If I hadn't zoomed in. Alright, we are done there. Go stairs down. Dark chamber. I believe as the melee fighter it would be very good to fight in zoomed in view, but as the range units it's better, range heroes, it's better to have it zoomed out. Boss.
What have you done with Ulrich?
I am here, Brink. I sent for Syl, but I don't recall inviting you or your friend. You may still prove useful, however.
Still!
He got transformed into a monster, I think. Boss. Let's retreat for now. So, fuck if they can't reach down. Heal ourselves. Have the zombies. So that's the boss of this place.
Insufficient mana.
Kill the beast. Let's refill our mana now. Attack it. Some more zombies arrive. Fight that beast. Nice. Let's heal. Attack it from far.
I don't have enough mana.
Let's refill the mana.
Insufficient mana.
Fill the mana again.
Don't have enough mana.
And even more mana. Let's heal myself up.
Insufficient mana.
And he's dead. Awesome.
Brink.
happened? Alas, my friend.
I would have loved to place this character. It looks exactly like one of my favorite characters in Diablo 2, the Sorceress. But I also like the Amazon. Alright.
You say this is Ulrich's doing? And his summons was a trap. But why? The corruption here must have overwhelmed his mind. I can't believe it's so powerful. Yes. See, it's touched you as well. Light is spreading through you. And if we don't find a way to stop it, you'll meet the same fate as Brink. I'm sorry I brought you into this. I'll do my best to cure you. Meet me in Torchlight, and I'll tell you my plan.
You have gained a task.
Let's get all the stuff first.
I'm overburdened.
So I'm overboard burdened again. Alright. Let's use the town portal then. And speak to this guy. We need to sell some bad stuff. Rom's rogue hide tunic. Right click to drink. Permanently increases defense by 2. That's awesome. Sell some stuff first. Alright. And then inventory. We need to identify some stuff. We have a Crescent Pelt of the Turtle, 7 armor.
Not possible.
Why can't we use this? It's a shield. Requires defense. 15. Have that. Probably it's the wrong class. Alright. Identified ring. 3% faster for cast speed. 6% plus 6 fire damage. Alright. Yeah, and then we have some other stuff we can identify. Brave leather crest. Plus 3 strength, every one is resistant.
Not possible.
Alright. 4 armor, 3 armor, plus 2 strength, 2 electro resistance, 4 armor, plus 2 mana. I still think this is better, so we'll keep it. And then we will identify this thing. Rainy Buckle Tunic of the Winds, 11 armor instead of 9 armor. Plus 6 electrical resistance, plus 2-3 mana, 50% chance to reflect, 50% of missile damage. Actually, that's better, but I need strength 11 to use it. So we will wait with that. We haven't gone up a level yet. Let's identify the Azure Leather Crest. 4 armor. Plus 20 health, increase all ice damage by 3%. Alright. We added that one, and then we have the staff there. Chilling Baton of Venom. But it's not for my character class. That's a ring, we could equip it to the pet. We're done here. We need amulets and spells for the pet as well. Alright, let's sell some more stuff. Level 4. Sell it. Alright, we're done there. Chilling Baton of Venom. We need higher level. But we don't need that. It's for another class, for the Alchemist. We need more strength to get this gun, this tunic. We don't need a shield either. Alright, we're done there. We have 2783 gold. Let's go back to the cave and hope that the stuff is still there. No, most of it was gone. Fuck. Had wanted some stuff, but we had some chests to open. Yeah, there were some stuff still laying about. Good. Inventory scrolls, mana potions. I had a full inventory, so I couldn't equip them properly. Are there any enemies here? There's some chests here as well. There were certainly stuff to do here. Stairs down, way gate to town. Let's go to the town first then. Speak to this lady. It isn't worth a risk. I've already heard that. Let's speak to this guy. Hey there, stranger. Welcome to Torchlight. I'm Hatch, richest man in town. Well, that's my plan anyhow. I haven't worked out all the details yet, but the key is this here wand. It opens a portal to one particular spot, and I'm sure it must be full of treasure. Problem is, it's also full of monsters, so I can't have a look for myself. If you can handle the monsters and bring me the best treasure you find in there, you can keep any gold and weapons for yourself. Be careful though. I don't think any other portals will work in there. What do you say? Except...
You have gained a task.
Let's speak to her again.
I'm a bit overwhelmed, friend. Brink is dead, my master is lost, and I feel responsible for your corruption as well. Somehow the blighted ember is fusing with your flesh, changing it. But at least the progress is slowed. I have some knowledge of the crypts below the mine. The Overseer experimented with methods of purifying amber. You may be able to use his knowledge to purge the corruption from you now. Find the Overseer's library. His notes should be there.
Alright, new quest. Let's go to the merchant again. Right, nothing to do there. We will identify some stuff. Swift saber. An insulating copper ring. Plus 11 electrical resistance. 1% increased gold find. Let's see. The pet. Alright, we will use this one instead for the pet. And then we have some more stuff to identify there. 2 sting copper ring, plus 4 fire resistance, plus 4 poison damage. Identify scroll, braced leather, vambrace, Christ level 6. See, I need to go, but we can speak to this guy too. You've slain a horrible bad creature, Vorkasir. I could see it in your eyes as soon as you approached. I can imagine the battle now. It will make a fine ballad. Well, the beginning one at least. I think this collaboration may be a boon to us both. Good. Let's speak to him and get the new quest. Even these dull miners will be able to appreciate this tale. Kunmur the Despoiler lurks 5 floors below Torchlight. Meet him in battle and I will weave an epic tale of your victory or your defeat. Really, I think either shall work perfectly, wonderfully. Except we got a new quest there.
What can I do?
We can't do anything there currently. We need to check that there are no new missions here. This is the gambling interface. All of the merchants' items have unknown properties. You'll have to purchase them. Find out what they do. Even every item is guaranteed to be magical. Right. All right, I will quit here for now. I will come back soon. See ya. Hello, so I'm back. Miss Nygren here. I had to go pee. Oh, however, we're back now. So my character is at level 5. It's almost the same level as the other character. We are back in the town for now. Sign remaining stat points. Sure. We want strength 11. And then we could do some magic points, maybe. Yes. So that's done. The skill. So, Frost Pilum. Fire a piercing ice projectile from a ranged weapon. Or this one. Critical strikes. Increases the chance to and improves the damage of at all critical strikes. Sure. You get both of those. Seems to be a limited number of spells. We can have only 4 at one time. Alright. Summon zombies. Needle arc. Fling an arc at 5 darts that pierces foes. Frost pylum. Let's take that now. So the chest. Let's move all the gems to the chest. I don't know if I will use them anytime soon. And then we will use the Brom's Roguehide Tunic. It will permanently increase our defense by 2, so sure. And then we have some other stuff. We'll identify this axe here, powerful simple axe. We'll sell it. We have a new lemon leather tunic, 6 armor. Let's take a look at it. What? Lemon leather tunic, 6 armor. What happened to the other one? What the fuck? It was just replaced. That sucks. So I managed to somehow replace the better one with that one, but it didn't return here. Jo, it did. They look exactly the same though. No difference in looks. Alright, brainy buckle tunic of the winds. Now we have a new look. This one is better. The other one from behind looked like that. Alright, and then we take the new one, brainy buckle tunic of the winds. Much better. Alright, and braid leather vambress. You need to be level 6 for that one, for those gloves. Alright, let's go back to the chest. Place in the rings for now. Inventory. Speak to the merchant again. Sell this swift saber. And the axe, we don't need it. Leather suit. Don't need any of those. And we're done here. Maybe there's something we can buy it here. We have 3147 gold. Weapons. Armor.
Good luck to you.
What can I do for you?
Have some spells here. Crack life ember. Spell haste, learn haste 2. Alright, summon flaming sword, requires level 7. Learn heal all, requires level 1. Learn haste 1. too. Alright. Flaming sword would be nice, but summons an enchanted flaming sword to attack your foes. They need to be level 7.
See you later.
Character is at level 5 currently.
I got the finest cut gems and amber.
Have some staffs there. Speak to this guy. No.
Farewell.
Well, hello. Good luck to you.
Alright, you're done here. I think we will check this place too. Armor. Have a pretty good armor, a blue one. We don't need that. However, we could use probably some better other stuff. $1592 for left spiked torso. We need more dexterity for it, and level 9. Blue buckled shoulders. Right, blue buckled shoulders. It's better, but it's kinda costly. Weapons, however. Our weapon is a very rare one, so we don't need a new weapon. This one is green. Buckled shoulders. +2 fire resistance, increases all ice damage by 4%. +2 armor. Buckled Blades of the Turtle, +4 armor, requires level 5. +4 armor. Actually, that's pretty good. I don't know. Deflecting Torn Shield. We don't need shields. Oh, we have something here as well. Clever buckled solaret of the turtle. It's boots. So 652, 806, 574. Alright, let's do this. We bought those boots. Hand buckler. We have some vice buckled clasp, rare helmet. Rare helmet, 599, 841. Alright. Let's buy that too. For the gloves. Rare chest armor. Level 9. Don't need armor or weapon. Shoulder armor could be used. 56, 921. Alright, we're done. And we're now updated. We look like this. It looks already better. Lots of blue stuff all of a sudden. Hairstyle was changed too. All right, but we still have gloves that are green, rings that are green. Switch active weapon at press V. We can have two weapons. Let's speak to the guy again. Armor. Could use some gloves. We have green gloves there. Helmet, rare shoulder armor. Rare helmet. Helmet. Boots. We didn't have that good gloves, unfortunately. Alright, we're done here. We'll take the town portal back because I need to finish that area where I were already. This portal is for the mission, but I prefer this one currently. Alright, the waypoint. We could only take that part. Stashed down.